You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show. Good morning, boys and girls. That's right, I'm Alex Manners, and welcome to my live Solihull Radio Children's Show on this wonderful, wonderful, wonderful Sunday morning. Well, I've got lots of fantastic things coming up for you today, including a host of songs to get you moving and grooving for the rest of your weekend. I've got some excerpts from some old children's shows to play for you. I've got some jokes, some facts, and Rainbow Man will be going on another wonderful, wonderful, wonderful adventure to another place within our local area that you could all go on with him and go and visit that wonderful, wonderful place. And today, Rainbow Man will be visiting the Birmingham Botanical Gardens in Edgbaston in the centre of Birmingham. So if that all sounds really, really exciting, then stay tuned right here for my live Solihull Radio Children's Show, where I will be here right up until 10 a.m. And we've got a new texting in number today, so if you would like to text in any birthday messages, then you can text those in on 8228 starting with studio. That's 8228 starting with studio. So if that all sounds really, really exciting, then don't forget to text in all of your birthday messages. And also, do you know what day it is today? Yes, that's right, because today is Mother's Day. So if you have any Mother's Day messages that you would like to send in, then again, you can text those in to 82228. That's 8228, starting with studio. So the two excerpts of those children's shows that I'm going to be playing for you today are excerpts from Rosie and Jim, a classic children's show, and another one called Little Bear. So see if any of you remember these two theme songs.
Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, chugging along on the old rag doll. Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, and John, he steers the boat. We go to play and have a look
with Rosie's bag,
Jim's drawing book. The world just by the window frame, and Rosie and Jim, we play our games. Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, finding stories every day. Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, and John, he writes them down. Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, chugging along on the old rag doll. Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, and John, he steers the boat. We go to play and have a look
with Rosie's bag,
Jim's drawing book. The world just by the window frame, and Rosie and Jim, we play our games. Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, finding stories every day. Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, and John, he writes them down.
I hope you all remembered, or some of you remembered, those two theme songs for Rosie and Jim and Little Bear, because a little later on in my show, I've got some old excerpts of those two shows to play for you. And if there were any mothers out there, then we wish you all a very, very happy Mother's Day. And I would like to give a shout out and say a very, very happy Mother's Day and wish my own mum a very, very happy Mother's Day. And we hope she has a wonderful, wonderful day. Well, here are two songs to get you moving and grooving for the rest of my show. A Bob the Builder song, Can We Fix It? And a CBeebies presenter's happy song. And hopefully these two songs will certainly make you happy for the rest of my show and the rest of your weekend.
Twist. the beat.
Got the moves, now you know. Smile and let your happy show. Whoa. Wave your arms, stomp your feet, sing a happy song. Do a twist, turn around, join and clap along. Feeling good, feeling great, let everybody know. Shake a groove to the beat. Smile and let your happy show.
Smile and let your happy show.
Yes, smile and let your happy show, and I'm certainly smiling here today in the studios. Well, I've got the first excerpt of one of those old children's shows to play for you, and the first excerpt is from Rosie and Jim, and it's called Gingerbread Man. So here we go with Rosie and Jim, the two rag dolls from Stratford-upon-Avon, and Gingerbread Man.
Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, chugging along on the old rag doll. Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, and Patchy steers the boat. We go to play and have a look with Rosie's back, Jim's boring book. The world drifts by the window frame, and Rosie and Jim, we play our games.
Wah.
Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, finding pictures every day. Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, and Patchy colours them in.
Now, I've drawn the canal, and I've drawn the ragdoll boat. Now, who shall I put on it? I know.
Rosie.
Yeah?
That Pat, she's drawing.
Jim, that's Pat. Loopy Lobes.
Loopy Lobes, Rosie.
Good. That's that picture finished. What I need is some good ideas for a picture on this page. Life jacket.
Quack, 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 quack.
Thanks, Dad. We're moving, Rosie.
Where are we going to, Jim?
Let's see.
Is.
Yeah, that's you, Rosie.
Oh, yeah. Jim?
Hmm?
Where are we going?
Rosie?
Uh-oh.
Rosie? I don't think Loopy Lobes knows where she's going.
Jim, let's go and see.
Yeah.
Those biscuits look good. Where did you get them from?
I got them from the bakery down there.
Oh.
Oh, a duck
biscuit.
Yeah, a quack nibble quack biscuit. Oh, Jim. He's bit duck's head off.
Oh, dear, doesn't like that.
Oh, dear.
I feel a bit hungry. I think I'll go and get some of those biscuits. Hello, I'm I'm Pat.
Good morning, I'm Steve the baker.
I've come for some of those lovely biscuits that I heard about.
That's right, these biscuits here.
Nibble quack, nibble quack, nibble quack, biscuits!
Quack, nibble quack, quack.
Yeah, come on!
We make them in the bakery.
You do?
Would you like to come through and see them made?
Oh, I'd really like that.
Come through.
That'd be wonderful, thank you.
Quack, nibble quack!
Oh, it's lovely, isn't it?
Right. What I've got to do, I've just got to finish rolling the dough. And then I've got to choose a cutter. Would you like to choose a cutter?
Very nice shapes, but I think my pig's nice.
Tim, he's doing a pig shape.
Pig shape.
And a cow.
Yeah.
Moo.
Oh, and a duck.
Yes?
That's my favourite shape of all. Can I have a duck, please?
Shape roses. Quack, quack!
Two more shapes to finish this tray. Then we'll take them through to bake them. Okay, the oven's this way.
They've gone, Jim.
Oh, you're baker Rosie Rosie.
I know. One.
One duck.
Two ducks. Three ducks.
Pat a cake, baker Rosie. Cut me a duck as fast as you can. One duck.
Yeah.
Two ducks.
There.
Now run it.
Bake me a duck.
As fast as you can.
Well, I don't remember cutting these ducks.
Neither do I.
Never mind. I'll cut a gingerbread man.
Yep.
We'll take these through and bake them.
Yeah.
Bake me a duck as fast as you can.
Quack!
Quack!
Just going to decorate them and then they'll be ready to eat.
Good. Feeling really hungry now.
Ready to eat, Jim.
Yum, yum, yum.
Oh, thank you. So interesting seeing the biscuits made. Really enjoyed it. I have to have some.
All right, which ones would you like?
Well, I've got to have a cow.
Cow.
Sheep.
Yeah, sheep.
Oh, and I've got to have a duck.
Special duck.
Special
this one?
Duck. Yes, that one, please. Thank you.
All right. And how about a gingerbread man?
Oh, yes, my gingerbread
okay.
man. Okay. That's wonderful. Thank you. And how much does that cost?
I've got it, Jim.
Where's my gingerbread man gone?
Run, run as fast as you can!
You can't catch me! I'm a gingerbread man!
Excuse me.
Run, run as fast as you can!
I can't catch you, little gingerbread man!
Jim, stop it!
Ah, lovely.
Jim, I can eat that.
Rosie, you naughty!
Oh, yummy, yummy!
Rosie, look, he's coming!
Oh, duck, open wide! There!
Duck, you've got my gingerbread man. And it looks as though you've eaten half of it. Never mind. Now I've got a good idea for a picture.
Good. That's that picture finished.
Ooh. Rosie.
Yeah?
There's a Rosie biscuit.
Yeah, and Jim, look, there's a Jim biscuit.
Yeah.
And look, Duck's eating a Jim biscuit.
But Rosie.
Yeah?
Where's a ducky biscuit?
Oh, Jim, there's a ducky biscuit.
Yeah.
Wah.
Listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show.
All the grand old Duke of York, he had 10,000 men. He marched them up to the top of the hill and he marched them down again. And when they were up, they were up. And when they were down, they were down. And when they were only halfway up, they were neither up nor down. He marched them up to the top of the hill and he marched them down again. And when they were up, they were up. And when they were down, they were down. And when they were only halfway up, they were neither up nor down.
That was The Grand Old Duke of York by Justin Fletcher, and I've had some more Mother's Day messages sent in. So I would like to wish mothers Jenny and Jill a very, very happy Mother's Day with lots of love from Julie and Andrew. So Jenny and Jill, if you're listening, then everyone here at Solihull Radio and Andrew and Julie wish you a very, very happy Mother's Day. And we hope you have a wonderful, wonderful day and do lots and lots of really, really enjoyable things. And don't forget, if anyone else has any wonderful, wonderful Mother's Day messages that they would like me to read out on my show, then they can do so by texting in 82228. That's 82228, starting with studio. Yes, I'll say that again. It's 82228, starting with studio. And I've now got a story to read for all you boys and girls. And the story I'm going to be reading for you today is called 006 and a Bit by Kez Gray and Nick Sharrett. So I hope you all really, really enjoy listening to this story called 006 and a Bit by Kez Gray and Nick Sharrett. Daisy had made up her mind. She wasn't going to be a girl anymore. She was going to be a spy. She had drawn a spy's moustache on her top lip with a black felt-tip pen. She had found some dark glasses in a drawer. She had found some secret spy gadgets in her mum's bedroom. All she had to do now was speak in code. Code is a special spy language that only spies understand. Daisy had seen it used in spy films. Now this time, it was for real. Daisy frowned mysteriously and crept unseen into the kitchen. "Hello, Daisy," said Mum. "What do you want for tea tonight?" "The ostriches will be swimming in tomato sauce this evening," said Daisy. "Which, as any spy knows, means a big portion of chicken nuggets and lots of ketchup, please." Daisy's mum stared at Daisy and scratched her head. "Why are you speaking all silly words?" asked Daisy's mum. "They're not silly words," whispered Daisy mysteriously. "It's a secret spy language, and my name isn't Daisy anymore. It's 006 and a bit." "And what are you intending to do with my hairbrush, 006 and a bit?" asked Daisy's mum. "It's not a hairbrush. It's my secret spy telephone," said Daisy. "And where are you going with my perfume bottle?" asked Daisy's mum. "It's not your perfume bottle," said Daisy. "It's my invisible ink." "And would I be wrong in thinking that is my hairdryer?" said Daisy's mum. "Yes," whispered Daisy. "It's not a hairdryer. It's my secret baddie zapper." Daisy's mum shook her head and went to find the ironing board. 006 and a bit slipped invisibly into the back garden. "Hello, Daisy," said her neighbour. "How are you today?" "Good afternoon, Agent Goldfish," said Daisy. "Are your fins green or purple today?" "Which, as any spy knows, means, 'I'm fine, thanks, Mrs. Pike. How are you?'" Mrs. Pike stared strangely at Daisy and went to mow her grass. Daisy slipped invisibly across the garden and went to give an important message to Mrs. Pike's cat. "Meet me by the Golden Palace," she whispered, "and bring your furry overcoat," which, as any spy know, means, "Hello, Tiptoes, why don't you come and sit by the shed? I want to stroke you." Tiptoe took one look at Daisy's hairdryer and skedaddled over the wall. Daisy dabbed on some more invisible ink and peeped out of the garden gate. "No one will be able to see me now," she smiled. "Hello, Daisy," said her best friend Gabby. "Can you come out and play? The laundry basket is full, and the big busy beaver has many clothes to fold," Daisy said. Which, as any spy know, means, "Hi, Gabby, I'll just ask my mum. She's doing the ironing." But Gabby gave Daisy a very strange look and went to find someone else to play with. Daisy took off her glasses and walked miserably back indoors. "What's the matter, 006 and a bit?" asked her mum. "Aren't you playing spies anymore?" "No, I'm not," sighed Daisy. "No one understands my spy language. They just look at me as though I'm silly." Daisy's mum stopped ironing and put her arm around Daisy's shoulders. "That must be because they're not real spies," whispered her mum. "If they were, they would understand everything you are saying." Daisy trudged into the living room and slumped onto the sofa. "Well, they don't understand what I'm saying. There aren't any real spies around here. No one understands me, and I'm not being a spy anymore. Being a spy is stupid," she grumbled. Daisy was just about to turn on the TV when a mysterious-looking stranger with a purple moustache and beard poked its head around the door. He had dark glasses on, just like Daisy. "Psst," whispered the stranger in a deep, mysterious voice. "Have you seen 006 and a bit anywhere?" Daisy stared back at the stranger in surprise. She put her dark glasses on again quickly and sat up straight. "Yes, I have seen 006 and a bit," she nodded. "That's me. I am 006 and a bit." "That is good news," whispered the stranger, "because my name is 0021 and a bit. I am a real spy too." The coloured sprinkles will be meeting with the chocolate flakes on the vanilla ice cream at tea time, whispered 0021 and a bit. And the crunchy cream biscuits and lemonade will be meeting under the big yellow duvet when the clock strikes 12, continued the mysterious stranger. 006 and a bit frowned for a moment and clapped her hands excitedly. Oh, goody, I know what that means. We're having my favourite pudding for tea, and then a midnight feast in your bed tonight. I'll bring my comics and a torch too. Which, as anybody knows, means, thanks, Mum, you're the best spy in the world. And that story was 006 and a bit by Kez Gray and Nick Sharrett. You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show. And the next song I'm going to play for you is a song from Disneyland, and it's called It's a Small World.
It's a world of laughter, a world of cheers. It's a world of hopes and a world of fears. There's so much that we share that it's time we're aware. It's a small world after all. 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 It's a small, small world. If it's Freddy Red and a soy plum, if it's hope.
And today, because one of the excerpts that I'm going to be playing for you is called Little Bear, I thought that I would read you some fun, fascinating and fabulous facts all about bears. So here we go with 7 fun, fabulous and fascinating facts all about bears. And fun, fabulous and fascinating fact number 1 is bears are large mammals that eat mostly meat and fish. Many bears also eat plants, bulbs, and insects. Fun, fascinating, and fantastic fact number 2 is the dawn bear was the first bear. It lived more than 10 million years ago. Wow, I didn't know that the first ever bear was called the dawn bear, living 10 million years ago. Maybe you can tell all your friends that fact at school. Fun, Fascinating and fantastic fact number three is that koalas are not bears. They are marsupials. And a distinctive characteristic common to marsupials is that most of the young are carried in a pouch. And fun, fascinating fact number four. A family or a group of bears is called a sloth. A male bear is a boar. Females are called sows. And baby bears are called cubs. And fun, fascinating fact number five. A polar bear might look white, but that's because we only see the white fur. Underneath the fur, the polar bear actually has black skin. Wow, I didn't know that polar bears have black skin. And fun, fascinating and fantastic fact number six is that bears are related to walruses, seals and sea lions. And for the final fact, fun, fascinating and fantastic fact number seven, there are only 8 living species of bears and they can be found throughout most of the world. So, those were the fun, fascinating and fantastic facts all about bears. Weren't they interesting? And here is another song, and it's Tangled, I See the Light.
All those days watching from the windows, all those years outside looking in, all that time never even knowing just how blind I've been. Now I'm here blinking in the starlight, now I'm here suddenly.
Something for you too. I should have given it to you before, but I was just scared. And the thing is, I'm not scared anymore. You know what I mean?
I'm starting to.
All those days chasing down a daydream, all those years living in a blur, all that time never truly seeing things the way they were. Now she's here, shining in the starlight. Now she's here, suddenly I know. If she's here, it's crystal clear. I'm where I'm meant to go. And at last I see the light. And it's like the fog is lifted, and at last I see the light.
And it's like the sky is new,
and it's warm and real and bright, and the world is somehow shifted. All at once, everything now that I see you. Now that I see you.
Can anyone think of any famous bears? Well, here are a few famous bears. We have Winnie the Pooh, Paddington Bear, Rupert Bear, Baloo from the Disney film The Jungle Book, Yogi Bear, and can anyone remember the bear from The Muppet Show? Yes, that's right, the bear from The Muppet Show is called Fozzie Bear. And here is an excerpt of another bear called Little Bear. And the excerpt is called Little Bear Gone Fishing. So I hope you all enjoy listening to Little Bear and Gone Fishing. Here we go.
Mother Bear, what are you cooking?
I thought I'd make a nice fish soup for supper.
Fish soup? Did you hear that, Father Bear? We're having your favorite soup. When's Father Bear coming home?
Soon, Little Bear. But not soon enough to bring a fish for tonight's soup. I'll have to go buy one.
I know. I'll bring you a fish, just like Father Bear would.
Little Bear, if you want to fish, do it outside.
Okay. If Father Bear can catch big fish, so can I. Hello, Owl.
Why, hello, Little Bear. What are you doing here?
I'm going to catch a fish for tonight's supper.
Oh, very nice, very nice. I suppose it's time for me to think about supper as well. Let's see now. The winds are out of the south, southwest, and the tide is low.
Is that good?
I believe it is, nautically speaking. Very well done.
Father Bear taught me.
Blow the man down, oh, blow the man down. Hey, ho, blow the man down.
What's that?
A fisherman's song. Blow the man down, oh, blow the man down. Hey, ho, blow the man down.
Whoa, I think I got one.
Don't pull too hard. Don't ease up.
Whoa!
Pull! Push! You got
Whoa.
Him!
Is it too tiny?
Looks fine to me.
Busy day fishing.
Don't you think you should... I mean, even though you already caught a very nice fish, it might be wise for you to keep fishing.
I know what. I'll be Father Bear. You can be you, and we are fishing.
Where are we fishing?
On the ocean.
Blow the man down, blow the man down.
Look at all the fish!
What is it?
A trout?
Well, that's not a trout. Maybe it's a flounder.
What did you catch?
Looks like a halibut to me.
What's a halibut?
My favorite kind. Whoa!
What is it?
I don't know. There's something on my line that's big.
Don't lose it. Keep pulling it in. Throw it back. An octopus can be dangerous.
That was close. We'd better turn the boat around.
Hey, Skipper! I've got something, too!
What do you think it is?
I don't know. It's real big.
Let me help.
Full rider!
Don't let it get away! It's a whale.
Hello, whale.
It doesn't look too friendly. Throw it back! Oh, no!
There you are. What are you doing under the log?
We were just about to be eaten.
Eaten?
Yes, by a whale.
A whale? Really? How exciting.
It was exciting. Al and I were fishing on this big boat. I caught a trout, or maybe it was a flounder.
Slow down, little bear.
Then Owl caught a halibut, and then he caught an octopus, and then all of a sudden... Say, where is Owl? Owl!
Right here, little bear.
Weren't you scared, too?
Scared? Me? Oh, no. Oh, no. Not at all.
And did you catch any fish?
Oh, yes. Right here. My fish! It's gone!
Gone?
I had a fish. A real little fish. One I actually caught. There was a fish here, Mother.
Of course there was.
Oh. Little Bear, your fishing rod. There's your fish.
It looks like the perfect fish for my soup. More soup, Owl?
Oh, I couldn't, Mother Bear. But thank you, it was scrumptious.
Little Bear?
Yes, please. It's a delicious fish, if I do say so myself. Someday, when I'm as big as Father Bear, I'm going to go out on a big boat and catch a big fish.
Yes, you will.
And I'll catch a real octopus, too. And maybe even a whale.
I don't know about octopus and whales, but you will certainly sail in a real boat.
Little Bear already fishes very well, don't you think?
Yes, he's a real fisherman. Just like his father.
Exactly. Just like his father.
Exactly.
You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show. Well, wasn't that exciting? All about Little Bear going fishing. And if you fancy joining Rainbow Man on his adventures today to the Birmingham Botanical Gardens, where he'll be going with his friends, then you can do so after these two tweeny songs. So, boys and girls, you can get moving and grooving and jumping and jiving for the rest of your weekend with these two tweeny songs.
Oh, I like this one. It's Come On, Feel the Music.
Oh, yes. I'm feeling tingly already.
We have to wave our arms first. Oh, I've started already.
Oh. Come on, feel the music.
Yeah.
It's a song you'll get to know. It will tingle in your fingers. It will tingle in your toes. Start your arms a-waving. Wave them all around. Keep those hands a-waving to the magic music sounds. Are you waving your arms?
Hey!
Let the music play.
Oh, yeah. I like waving my arms.
We have to tap our feet now.
Come on, feel the music. It's a song you'll get to know. It will tingle in your fingers. It will tingle in your toes. Start your feet a-tapping. Tap them all around. Keep your feet a-tapping to the magic music sounds. Are you tapping your feet?
Hey!
Let the
the music play.
Tell from my favourite verse. Moving your whole body.
Come on, feel the music. It's a song you'll get to know. It will tingle in your fingers. It will tingle in your toes. Start your body moving. Moving all around. Keep your body moving to the magic music sounds. Are you moving your body? Hey! Let the music play.
Clapping hands this time. Oh, yeah. Here we go! Whoa!
Come on, feel the music.
Yeah!
It's a song you'll get to know. It will tingle in your fingers.
Yeah!
It will tingle in your toes. Start your hands a-clapping.
Yeah!
Clap them all around. Keep your hands a-clapping to the magic music sounds. Clapping your hands, hey! Let the music play.
Whoa!
Are you moving your body? Hey! Let the music play. Are you tapping your feet? Hey! Let the music play. Are you waving your arms? Hey! Let the music play.
A farm. We've got to be an animal and the others can visit.
Do we?
Yes, the song, Jake. You know, I went to visit a farm one day.
Come on then. How first? We have to make our fingers into little horns.
I went to visit a farm one day. I saw a cow across the way. And what do you think I heard it say?
Moo, moo, moo.
Moo, moo, moo.
I'd like to see a pig next. Ooh, and we could all do piggy noses as well.
Say woof woof and wag our tails like doodles.
Oh, yeah. Come on then, everyone. Get ready to flap your wings and wiggle your tail.
I went to visit a farm one day. I saw a duck across the way. And what do you think I heard it say?
Quack, quack, quack. Quack, quack, quack.
Right, one more for Doodles.
What do you want to see, Doodles?
A cow.
Oh, but we've had a cow.
But I like cows.
Oh, yeah, you can have a cow, Doodles. Doodles likes cows better.
Oh, all right, we'll do a cow again. But we have to do a different action.
Oh, what about those little dangly things that they have hanging down?
Yes, good idea, Milo. We can bend over and use our hands to dangle down like those, sort of dangly things. Are you ready?
Yeah!
Bend over like this.
I went to visit a farm one day.
What are you doing?
And here is Rainbow Man, where you can join him on his adventures. And today, he will be going and visiting the Birmingham Botanical Gardens in Edgbaston, in the centre of Birmingham. And you can now go on the adventure and join him at the Birmingham Botanical Gardens with Rainbow Man and his friends. Here we go.
He is here, he is there, Rainbow Man is everywhere. Seek him here, seek him there, see him in his rainbow chair. Hello, Rainbow Man. I wonder where you are going today. Rainbow Man stands up from his chair and points his finger in the air. Then he sits down with a puzzled look on his face. You look a bit confused, Rainbow Man. Is it because you have forgotten where you are going today? Rainbow Man nods. Well, Rainbow Man, you will be visiting the Birmingham Botanical Gardens today. Rainbow Man suddenly stands up. Right, time for an adventure. Off we go. Rainbow Man zooms up in his chair and starts swirling around with lots of colourful swirls. Swirling here, swirling there. Rainbow Man goes everywhere. Rainbow Man appears in the car park outside the Birmingham Botanical Gardens. You have arrived outside the Birmingham Botanical Gardens, Rainbow Man. Shall we go and have a look inside? Rainbow Man looks very excited and nods his head. What part of the gardens would you like to visit first, Rainbow Man? Rainbow Man thinks for a while. I think Rainbow Man wants to visit the birdhouse first. Well, I think that is a very good idea. To get to the birdhouse, you will have to go through the glasshouses. Do you know what a glasshouse is, Rainbow Man? Rainbow Man shakes his head. Well, a glasshouse is a huge glass building, like a giant greenhouse, that is used for growing plants in very specific conditions. We can visit the glasshouses later if you like. Rainbow Man nods his head and can't wait to come back to see all of the exotic plants. Over at the birdhouse, Rainbow Man spots his friend Giddy Gordon looking through a pair of binoculars. Look, Rainbow Man, Giddy Gordon is looking at the birds as well. Hello, Giddy Gordon. Giddy Gordon turns around and waves at Rainbow Man, then carries on looking at the birds through his binoculars. Giddy Gordon, I don't think you need a pair of binoculars to see the birds when they are that close to you. Giddy Gordon looks at Rainbow Man and then carries on looking at the birds through his binoculars. You're funny, Giddy Gordon. You even have your binoculars the wrong way round. The birds will look further away from you if you have them the wrong way round. Rainbow Man decides to leave Giddy Gordon to his bird watching and walks outside. Rainbow Man spots a parrot in one of the other cages. Wow, look at that. You have found a parrot, Rainbow Man. Rainbow Man really likes the parrot, as it is one of the most colourful birds he has seen. Isn't the parrot colourful, Rainbow Man? But I don't think he is as colourful as you. Rainbow Man agrees. Did you know that some parrots can copy what we say? Rainbow Man nods his head. You are very clever, Rainbow Man. Shall we go and visit the glasshouses now? Rainbow Man nods his head. Inside the glasshouses, Rainbow Man spots a world map in front of one of the olive trees. Wow, Rainbow Man, you have found an olive tree. Do you know where olive trees come from, Rainbow Man? Rainbow Man points at the North Pole on the map. No, Rainbow Man, olive trees don't come from the North Pole. They would not grow there as it is too cold. They come from the continent of Africa. Rainbow Man points at Africa on the map. That's right, Rainbow Man. Rainbow Man remembers seeing some very unusual looking plants and wants to go and have a look at them. I think the plants that you are thinking of are cacti, Rainbow Man. Let's go and see if we can find them. Over in the arid house, Rainbow Man has found a whole range of cacti plants. Rainbow Man is so surprised by these plants that he really wants to see what they feel like. Wait, Rainbow Man, you don't want to touch any of the cacti, as they are very spiky and prickly. Rainbow Man steps back. He does not want to get hurt. Don't worry, Rainbow Man. You won't get hurt just by looking at them. Rainbow Man then walks into a part of the glass house called the Tropical House, where it is really hot and sticky. Look up at the roof, Rainbow Man. Rainbow Man looks up and is taken aback. That is a palm tree, Rainbow Man. It is very big, isn't it? Rainbow Man nods. Look at the pond behind you, Rainbow Man.
you may be able to spot some fish. Rainbow Man walks over to the pond to see if he can spot any fish. Can you see any fish in there, Rainbow Man? Rainbow Man points to some really big fish that he can see in the pond. They are very big fish. Can you count how many there are? Rainbow Man starts to count. 1, 2, 3. Rainbow Man, is that 6 fish you have counted? Rainbow Man nods his head. I think we have seen all of the plants in the glass houses now. Let's go and have a look in the shop before we go. Over at the shop, Rainbow Man is fascinated by all of the things that are on sale. Look, Rainbow Man, they are selling lots of things. They have gifts, toys, lots of cards, and they even have a courtyard out the back of the shop full of plants that you can buy. Rainbow Man does not know what to look at first. Why don't we go and have a look at some of the plants outside, Rainbow Man? There is even a small greenhouse that we can go in. As Rainbow Man is walking over to the courtyard outside, where all of the plants are being sold, he spots a wall of really colourful items. What have you found, Rainbow Man? I think Rainbow Man has found the large wall of all different kinds of sweets. Grumpy Doug appears and looks at Rainbow Man, shaking his head. I don't think Grumpy Doug likes sweets, Rainbow Man. He is trying to tell you that they are very bad for you. I am afraid to say that Grumpy Doug is right, Rainbow Man. Sweets are very bad for you, as they contain lots of something called sugar. Looking very grumpy, Grumpy Doug points to a basket of fruit. I think Grumpy Doug wants you to eat some of the fruit instead, as it is very healthy for you. Rainbow Man stops looking at the sweets and goes over to the basket of fruit. If you would like to try one of the oranges or one of the apples, then you will first have to go and pay for them at the till. Rainbow Man picks up one of the oranges and goes and pays for it at the till. Let's eat it when we get home. Goodbye, Grumpy Doug. Rainbow Man waves goodbye to Grumpy Doug, and Grumpy Doug waves back. Well, that's all for today. It's time to go. Colourful swirls appear, and Rainbow Man starts swirling around with them. Swirling here, swirling there, Rainbow Man goes everywhere. Rainbow Man appears back at home in his rainbow chair. What an adventure! You really enjoyed yourself today at the Birmingham Botanical Gardens. Rainbow Man starts to cheer, woohoo! What was your favourite part of your day? Seeing all of the birds was my favourite part of the day as well, Rainbow Man. Rainbow Man smiles. I wonder where you will go on your adventure next time, Rainbow Man. Rainbow Man shrugs his shoulders. Well, goodbye, Rainbow Man. See you next time.
You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show. Well, that was a fantastic Rainbow Man story. And don't forget, if you would like to go on that adventure with Rainbow Man again to the Botanical Gardens in Birmingham, then you can go to YouTube and head to the Rainbow Man Children's Channel. Yes, that's YouTube, and you can head to the Rainbow Man Children's Channel. And here is another song. And hopefully it will get you all moving and grooving. And this song is a Bob the Builder song, so I hope you all enjoy listening to No Prob Bob.
When time is tight and life gets rough, or when my skies are grey, I ask my friends to lend a hand, and this is what they say.
I'm moving things up.
So, what fantastic, fantastic things are going on in our local area over the next few days and few weeks? Well, there's lots of wonderful, wonderful things going on, including something fantastic that's going on at the NEC. And at the NEC, there is a Kids Tropolis event from the 13th to the 15th of April. Kid Tropolis, the UK's best kids event, is packed full of live entertainment, toys, games, characters, and family brands. You will be able to see the Baby Shark mini show live on Saturday, the 13th of April, and you will also get to see CBeebies, Sam and Mark's live show, packed with fun, jokes, laughs, and games on Saturday, the 13th, and Sunday, the 14th of April. And you will also be able to go in a mega inflatable labyrinth assault course, a carousel, roller rink, and much, much more. So that is Kid Tropolis at the NEC from the 13th to the 15th of April. At Hatton Adventure World, they've got their Spring Spectacular from the 13th until the 28th of April. There will be Easter egg hunts. You will be able to see lots and lots of baby animals, join in with magic shows, Hatton's Grand National, tractor safaris, falconry displays, and lots, lots more. So that is Hatton Adventure World's Spring Spectacular from the 13th until the 28th of April. Then, at Touchwood, there is a fantastic event, which will be going on from Saturday the 13th to Sunday the 28th of April. Touchwood has a whole host of free code-cracking activities to keep chocolate fans of all ages entertained this Easter, with a code-cracking challenge trail for youngsters and a chocolate-themed escape room for older guests. You can count on Touchwood to put a spring in your step. From Saturday the 13th until Sunday the 28th of April, a mysterious locked safe will sit on the information desk filled with surprise treats. Those that crack the code can help themselves to a tasty reward. But it sounds easy enough. However, to get the all-important sequence of numbers, youngsters will first need to take part in a scavenger hunt around the centre. Children will be given a code-cracking sheet with hints and tips on the location of Touchwood's special Easter eggs, followed by instructions on how to crack the code. Uncover the correct numerical sequence and enjoy the sweet taste of victory. So that is at Touchwood, and the code-cracking pack with instructions can be picked up from the information desk. So if those events sound really, really exciting, then you can head down to the NEC for Kid Tropolis from the 13th till the 15th of April, Hatton Adventure World for their Spring Spectacular from the 13th until the 28th of April, or join in with Touchwood's code-cracking activities from the 13th until the 28th of April. So, if that all sounds interesting, then we have loads of wonderful events going on over our local area. Well, here is another song for you, and I hope it gets you moving and grooving.
Whistle white and a throttle back, and she blew, 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 blew.
And here is another excerpt from Rosie and Jim. And this excerpt from Rosie and Jim is called The Disappearing Sausages. So I hope you all enjoy listening to Rosie and Jim and The Disappearing Sausages. Here we go.
Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, chugging along on the old rando. Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, and Patsy steers the boat. We go to play and have a look with Rosie's back, Jim's boring book. The world drifts by the window frame, and Rosie and Jim, we play our games.
Wah.
Rosie and Jim, finding pictures every day. Rosie and Jim, and Patchy colours them in.
Now, I've drawn the canal, and I've drawn the ragdoll boat. Now, who shall I put on it? I know.
Rosie?
Yeah?
That Pat, she's drawing.
Jim, that Pat. Loopy lobes.
Loopy lobes,
Rose. Good. That's that picture finished. What I need is some good ideas for a picture on this page. Life jacket.
Wah, 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 wah.
Thanks, Doc.
Thanks, Doc. Ooh.
We're not moving, Rosie.
Why not?
Don't know. Let's see. Yeah.
Hello.
Jim. You see that there? Yeah. That's you, that is.
And Rosie.
Yeah.
That's you, that is.
Oh, yeah. Jim, why aren't we going anywhere?
Rosie.
Yeah.
There's Loopy Lou.
Hello. Where are you going with all those heavy suitcases?
On a boating holiday.
Boating holiday?
They just said holiday.
Yeah, they said boating holiday.
Rosie.
Yeah.
We could go on a boating holiday.
And Jim, this is a boat?
Yeah.
That looks very heavy. I'd like me to carry it for you. Come on then. Go. Phew. This case is heavy, Yvonne.
Ooh. Suitcase, Rosie.
It's for my holiday.
It's for your holiday. You're very lucky going on holiday. Now, should we go and see what your mum and dad are doing?
Hey, Jim, I've got a suitcase. Now all we've got to do is pack.
Going on holiday.
Yes.
Going on holiday.
More sponges.
Sausages as well, Rosie.
Jim, there's no room for those sausages. Get them out. I've not finished my packing. I have to pack my orange.
Going on holiday.
Jim, I said there isn't any room and I haven't finished packing yet. I've got to pack my shuttlecock.
Rosie,
get them out.
Don't take sausages, we won't have anything to eat.
Yeah, right, that's it now. We can close it up now. Close the lid. Are those sausages staying?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. Close the lid. Right now. Oh. Zip it up.
More sausages, Rosie.
No, Jim, we can't have any more sausages.
We need to pack more sausages.
Jim, I said no.
We need more.
No. Now, look. Oops. Okay, I'll go and get it.
Well done, Rosie.
See you soon, Jim. Ah, got it. Ooh.
Rosie?
Jim? Where's my sandals and my shuttlecock?
Where's my sausages?
Oh, no. Jim, this isn't our suitcase.
Roses, you picked up the wrong suitcase and they've gone off with our sausages.
Dad, I got sausages in my suitcase.
Not now, I'm cooking breakfast.
Oh dear! Jim, come on!
Quick!
Oh dear, they've forgotten their suitcase. Behind.
Oh, thank you.
That's yours too.
Yvonne, that is my suitcase. I don't remember packing all these sausages.
Sausages? Did someone say sausages? I just cooked some. Would you like one?
Oh, I'd love one, please. Yours?
Oh, no!
We're all eating sausages.
Oh, dear. Hang on, Jim.
Oh, that's not fair. All I want is a little sausage.
It's all right, Jim. I'm going to fix it.
Rosie?
What are you doing? Oh, it's all right, Jim. I'm going to rescue those sausages. Right.
Oh, yeah. That way a bit, Rosie. Oh,
that way a
bit. That way a little bit.
Oh, I've got them, Jim.
Yeah. Oh,
right. Hang on.
There they are.
Quick! Now I've got a good idea for a picture.
Oh.
duck.
Wah.
To Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show. What do you call a dinosaur that is sleeping? A dino snore. And here is a Disney song, and it's from Mary Poppins, and it's called A Spoonful of Sugar. So boys and girls, get bopping and jiving to A Spoonful of Sugar from Mary Poppins.
In every job that must be done, there is an element of fun. You find the fun, and snap, the job's a game. And every task you undertake becomes a piece of cake, a lark, a spree. It's very clear to see that a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down, medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way. A robin feathering his nest has very little time to rest while gathering his bits of twine and twig. Though quite intent in his pursuit, he has a merry tune to toot. He knows a song will move the job along. For a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down, medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way. The nectar from the flowers to the comb never tire of ever buzzing to and fro, because they take a little nip from every flower that they sip, and hence they find their task is not a
we'll be right back.
The time now is 9:28 and it's coming up to the last half an hour or so of my show this morning. But don't go anywhere because I've got lots and lots of more fantastic, fantastic things to play for you, including a story which I'm going to be reading for you. But if you have any more Mother's Day messages that you would like me to read out, then don't forget to text those Mother's Day messages in to 8228 starting with the word studio. That's 8228 starting with the word studio. And if you're all sitting really, really comfortably, then I shall read you this Walt Disney story. And it's another story about a bear. And can any of you guess which Walt Disney bear is the most famous? That's right, it's Winnie the Pooh. And this story is called Winnie the Pooh and Tigger 2. And it's a story from the 100-acre wood. So here we go. One morning, Winnie the Pooh was on his way to visit his friend Piglet. Although Pooh's head was stuffed with fluff, he was a cheerful fellow. As he walked along through the woods, he was humming a song to himself. Pooh did not look where he was going. All of a sudden, someone bounced into him. Pooh found himself flat on the ground. Tigger was sitting on his tummy. "Hello, Pooh," said Tigger. "It's a fine day for bouncing." Tigger helped Pooh to get up. "Thank you, Tigger," said Pooh. "I was just thinking, it's a fine day for going to visit Piglet." "I was on my way to see Rabbit," said Tigger, "but I will come along with you." And Tigger bounced away. Tigger bounced on ahead of Pooh. He bounced so fast, and he bounced so far, that he bounced right into Piglet. "Tigger," cried Piglet, "you scared me." "I'm sorry," said Tigger. He helped Piglet to get up. "Now I'm off to see Rabbit," said Tigger. "Why don't you and Pooh come with me?" Away he bounced again. Tigger bounced into Rabbit's garden. Rabbit was busy counting his carrots. Suddenly, Tigger bounced on top of him. "Hello there, Rabbit," said Tigger. "Tigger, you're a pest," cried Rabbit. When Pooh and Piglet reached the garden, they helped Rabbit to his feet. Rabbit was very angry at Tigger. "Why are you always so bouncy?" he cried. "Bouncing is what I do best," Tigger said, and he began to sing. The wonderful thing about Tiggers are wonderful things. Their tops are made of rubber, their tails are made of springs. They're bouncy, trouncy, flouncy, pouncy, full of fun, fun, fun. The most wonderful thing about Tiggers is that I'm the only one. By the time Tigger bounced away, Rabbit's whole garden was ruined. Later that day, Rabbit came up with a splendid idea for unbouncing Tigger. He told Pooh and Piglet about it. "We will take him on a long explore and leave him in the woods," said Rabbit. "When we go back to get him next morning, Tigger will not be so bouncy." "That is a splendid idea," said Piglet. "What do you think, Pooh?" But Pooh was sitting in a cozy chair, and he had fallen fast asleep. Piglet poked him. "I think it's a splendid idea," said Pooh, after Piglet told him all about it. The very next day, Rabbit, Pooh, and Piglet took Tigger into the woods. "When we come back to get Tigger tomorrow," said Rabbit, "the bounces will all be gone. He'll be a sad Tigger, a sorry Tigger." "A rabbit, I'm so glad to see you, Tigger." Tigger bounced further and further away. He did not know about Rabbit's idea to leave him in the woods. The three friends found a hollow log. "Quick," said Rabbit, "hide inside." They climbed into the log. Tigger soon came back to look for them. "Hello," he called. No one answered. Tigger stood on top of the log. He called to his friends again. They still did not answer. "They must be lost," thought Tigger, and he bounced away to find them. As soon as Tigger was out of sight, Rabbit, Pooh, and Piglet started home. After a while, they came to a sandpit. "Something is wrong," said Piglet. "I'm sure we passed by here before." "Nonsense," said Rabbit. "Keep walking." Soon, they came to the sandpit again. "I believe we're lost," said Pooh. "We have been looking for home, but we keep finding this sandpit. Maybe if we start looking for this sandpit, we will find our way home. I'm sure I know the way, said Rabbit. You two wait here, and I'll find it. Pooh and Piglet waited for Rabbit. They waited, and waited, and waited, but Rabbit did not come back. At last, Pooh took Piglet's hand. Let's follow my tummy, said Pooh. Whenever I get hungry for honey, my tummy leads me home. Sure enough, Pooh's tummy found the way. Just as they came out of the woods, Tigger bounced into them. Oh, Tigger, said Pooh, Rabbit is lost in the woods. Tiggers never get lost, said Tigger. I'll go back to find him. He bounced away. Meanwhile, Rabbit was all alone in the darkest part of the woods. He was very, very lost. Every time he looked around, he thought he saw someone watching him. He heard all sorts of scary sounds. Croak, peck, hiss, chomp, hoot. Then Rabbit heard someone creeping up in the bushes. Help, Pooh, help, Piglet, he shouted. Suddenly, he was bounced to the ground. Tigger, Rabbit cried. I am so glad to see you. Tigger led Rabbit out of the woods. Poor Rabbit. His splendid idea for unbouncing Tigger had not worked out very well. Bright and early the next morning, Tigger went to Kanga's house. Kanga was busily sweeping the yard. May I take Roo for a walk with me? Asked Tigger. Of course, dear, said Kanga. As Tigger bounced along, Roo rode on his back. Can Tiggers climb trees? Asked Roo. That's what Tiggers do best, said Tigger. I will show you. Tigger found a tall tree, and he bounced from branch to branch. He bounced up. Ooh, Tigger, squealed Roo. He bounced higher. Ooh, Tigger, Roo squealed again. He bounced higher and higher. Soon they were near the top of the tree. When Tigger looked down, he was very scared. How did this tree get so high? He cried. Isn't it fun? Said Roo. No, answered Tigger. I forgot to tell you. Tiggers can't climb down. Hooray, squealed Roo. We'll stay here forever. Just at that moment, Pooh and Piglet came by. They happened to look up at the tree. Piglet, whispered Pooh, there's a jugular. Are jugulars fierce animals? Cried Piglet. I'm not really sure, said Pooh. Let's walk a bit closer and see. When Pooh and Piglet reached the tree, they saw Tigger and Roo near the top. Hello, called Roo. Tigger is stuck. Don't worry, Tigger, called Pooh. We will get Christopher Robin. He'll think of a way to rescue you. Before long, Christopher Robin appeared. He ran to the tree with Rabbit and Kanga. I do hope Tigger has learned his lesson, said Rabbit. Maybe he'll stop bouncing now. Christopher Robin took off his coat. He told everyone to hold on to a corner so Roo could jump into it. After Roo came tumbling down, Christopher Robin called up to Tigger. Now it's your turn to jump, he said. Tiggers don't jump, they bounce, said Tigger. But if I ever get down from here, I promise never to bounce again. Did you all hear that? Cried Rabbit. He promised to stop bouncing. Tigger closed his eyes and let go of the tree. Down, down, down he fell. He landed on the coat with such a thump that everyone fell backwards. Tigger was happy to be down. He started to bounce. But Rabbit held up his hand. No bouncing, Tigger, he said. You promised never to bounce again. That's right, said Tigger. I did. Tigger began to walk away. Without his bounce, he was a very sad Tigger indeed. Roo watched his unhappy friend. I like the old bouncy Tigger better, he said. So do I, dear, said Kanga. So do I, said Pooh and Piglet. Everyone looked at Rabbit. Well, said Rabbit, so do I guess. All of a sudden, Tigger came bouncing back. Do you really mean it, Rabbit? He cried. May I have my bounce back? Yes, said Rabbit, I really mean it. Hooray, said Tigger, and off he bounced, happy to be his bouncy old self again. And that story was Walt Disney's Winnie the Pooh and Tigger too.
You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show.
What is fast, loud and crunchy? A rocket chip. And here are some more Disney songs to get you moving and grooving. So boys and girls, get on your feet and start waving those arms around with these wonderful, wonderful, wonderful Disney songs. Here we go, and I hope you enjoy them.
As old as time, true as it can be, barely even friends, then somebody bends unexpectedly. Just a little change, small to say the least, both a little scared, neither one prepared, Beauty and the Beast. Ever just the same, ever a surprise, ever as before, ever just as sure as the sun will rise. As old as time, tune as old as song, bittersweet and strange, finding you can change, learning you were wrong. Certain as the sun, rising in the east, tale as old as time, song as old as rhyme, Beauty and the Beast. Tale as old as time, song as old as rhyme, Beauty and the Beast.
Off to the cupboard with you now, Chip. It's past your bedtime. Good night, love.
I can see what's happening.
What?
And they don't have a clue.
Who?
They'll fall in love, and here's the bottom line. Our trio's down to two.
Oh.
The sweet caress of twilight. There's magic everywhere. And with all this romantic atmosphere, disaster's in the air.
To make her see the truth about my past, impossible. She'd turn away from me.
He's holding back, he's hiding, but what I can't decide. Why won't he be the king I know he is, the king I see inside?
Can you feel the love? The world
in love tonight. It can be assumed his carefree days with us are history. In short, our pal is doomed.
This morning, the clocks went forward by 1 hour. But do you know why the clocks go forward by 1 hour? Well, the reason the clocks go forward is because of a campaign years and years ago by a builder called William Willett, because he wanted to stop people wasting valuable hours of light in the summer months and to save fuel during the war. So that is why the clocks go forward at the end of March by 1 hour. But don't worry, because in 6 months they will go forward again by 1 hour. Well, here are some more Disney songs to get you moving and grooving for the rest of my show today.
I'm disgraced.
Who, you? Never. Gaston, you've got to pull yourself together. Gosh, it disturbs me to see you, Gaston, looking so down in the dumps. Every guy here'd love to be you, Gaston, even when taking your lumps. There's no man in town as admired as you. You're everyone's favorite guy. Everyone's awed and inspired by you. And it's not very hard to see why. No one's slick as Gaston. No one's quick as Gaston. No one's next as incredibly thick as Gaston. For there's no man in town half as manly. Perfect, a pure paragon. You can ask any Tom, Dick, or Stanley, and they'll tell you whose team they prefer to be on. No one's big like Gaston. Nothing big like Gaston. No one's got a swell cleft in his chin like Gaston.
As a specimen, yes, I'm intimidating.
I want a guy like Gaston. If I
Gaston is the best and the rest is all the rest.
No one
fights like Gaston, now he's like Gaston.
The rest of that's nobody fights like Gaston.
For there's no one as burly and brawny.
As you see, I've got biceps to spare.
Not a bit of him scraggly or scrawny.
That's right. And every last inch of me's covered with hair.
No one hits like Gaston.
In a spitting match, nobody spits like Gaston.
I'm especially good at expectorating. When I was a lad, I ate 4 dozen eggs every morning to help me get large. And now that I'm grown, I eat 5 dozen eggs, so I'm roughly the size of a barge.
Goes tromping around wearing boots like Gaston.
I use antlers in all of my decorating.
I want a guy, Gaston.
All that I needed
Hello again, boys and girls. Sorry I was a little slow there. Anyway, it's coming up to the last 7 minutes of my show today. But don't worry, because I've got lots of more wonderful, wonderful things coming up on my show for you next week. I've got lots of wonderful, wonderful songs to play for you. Some more excerpts from some old children's shows. I've got some more jokes, more facts. And Rainbow Man will be going on another wonderful, wonderful adventure with his friends Giddy Gordon, Grumpy Doug, and Awesome Alex. And don't forget, if you have any birthday messages that you would like to send in, then you can text those in to 8228 starting with the word studio. That's 8228 starting with the word studio. And also, you could text those in to studio@solihullradio.com. That's studio@solihullradio.com. Or if you would like to go on that adventure again with Rainbow Man, then you can head down to YouTube to the Rainbow Man Children's Channel. That's YouTube to the Rainbow Man Children's Channel. And don't forget, just like to get you moving and grooving. And this song is the CBeebies presenters. It's the weekend song. So I hope you all enjoy listening to this song and it gets you moving and grooving for the rest of my show today. So here we go with the CBeebies. It's the weekend song. Here we go.
Two special days at the end of the week. So many ways to have fun. Saturday and Sunday are waiting for you. The weekend has begun. It's the weekend. Saturday and Sunday too. It's the weekend. There's fun to have and things to do. It's the weekend. The time for family and friends. We see BBs. That weekend feeling never ends. You can visit friends. You can have them round to play. You can pop to town and shop. Go somewhere special for the day. Kick a football in the park. Perhaps ride on your bike. Make and do or bake a cake. There's just so much to like. It's the weekend. Saturday and Sunday too. It's the weekend. There's fun to have and things to do. It's the weekend. Great to get out and about. It's the weekend. It makes you sing, it makes you shout. It's the weekend. The time for family and friends. We see BBs. That weekend feeling never ends.
Would you like to listen to that again, boys and girls? Well, here we go.
Special days at the end of the week, so many ways to have fun. Saturday and Sunday are waiting for you. The weekend has begun. It's the weekend. Saturday and Sunday too. It's the weekend. There's fun to have and things to do. It's the weekend. The time for family and friends. We see BBs. That weekend feeling never ends. Visit friends, you can have them round to play. You can pop to town and shop, go somewhere special for the day. Kick a football in the park, perhaps ride on your bike. Make and do or bake a cake, there's just so much to like. It's the weekend, Saturday and Sunday too. It's the weekend, there's fun to have and things to do. It's the weekend. Great to get out and about. It's the weekend. It makes you sing, it makes you shout. It's the weekend. The time for family and friends. We see BBs. That weekend feeling never ends.
Well, I hope the weekend never ends. And whatever it is you're doing today, have a wonderful, wonderful day. And if you're doing anything with your mums, then we all hope they have a wonderful, wonderful Mother's Day. And don't forget to wish them a very, very happy Mother's Day. And whatever it is you've got planned for them, maybe you're going to make them breakfast in bed or cook them lunch. Or maybe you've made them and designed them a nice card. Well, any mothers out there, we hope you have a wonderful, wonderful Mother's Day and a really, really happy day with your families. And don't forget that we have lots more shows coming up for you all throughout the week with lots and lots more wonderful guests, music, songs and lots of wonderful, wonderful things like that every day of the week. Well, if you've enjoyed Finding the Disappearing Sausages with Rosie and Jim, going fishing with Little Bear, bouncing with Tigger, and visiting the Birmingham Botanical Gardens with Rainbow Man and his friends, then don't forget to join me, Alex Manners, next Sunday from my another live Solihull Radio Children show with lots more music, excerpts of old shows, stories, and lots more wonderful, wonderful things. So it's goodbye from me, Alex Manners, and it's goodbye from Rainbow Man. So until next week, au revoir. You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show.